take your plate and turn it over. Fast and pray without the church. Believe God like you're going to get the breakthrough anyhow. Tell your neighbor, I might not even know you. Come on, talk to them. Tell them, I might not even know you. Tell them, but I'm believing God for you anyhow. And the body is like, I'm trying to get out of here now. But every now and then, you got to learn how to turn your plate over and say, Lord, I'm waiting on you. And while you're doing it, what you're going to find out is that if you're willing to do this, that God will move you from nothing into something. You can't get to verse number 17 without passing by verses 1 through 3. And when you get by verses 1 through 3, you'll find out in verse number 4, he said, fear not. In verse number 5, he said, I'm your redeemer. He said, in verse number 6, I'm still calling your name. In verse number 7, I abandon you for a brief moment. In verse number 8, he said, I was angry, but for a little while. In verse number 9, he said, just like I told Noah, I'll never flood the whole earth again. I'll never flood you again. Verse number 10, he said, the mountains may move and hills may disappear, but my love for you will remain faithful. In verse number 11, he said, I will rebuild you. In number 12, he said, you're coming back. In verse number 13, he said, you'll have great peace. In verse number 14, he said, your enemies will stay far away. In verse number 15, he said, whoever attacks you is going down in defeat. In verse number 16, he said, I created the blacksmith and the person who fans the coal. But in verse number 17, he said, there are no weapons. Yes, that's formed against you. It's not going to prosper. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, whatever you're going through, but it's only a season, it's only a test. Believe.